So for this example, to show how reference cells work, it's really a fundamental part of Google Sheets and any spreadsheet software. When we have a formula, we can reference a cell or a range of cells, and that is how the formula knows what to calculate. So in this example, we're calculating a very simple current year budget, and to figure out next year's budget, we just want to take the current year's numbers and multiply by an inflation rate of, let's say, 2%. So what we do here is we take the cell B3, and then we multiply it by the inflation rate, which is here in cell B14. Now, we're going to say 2%, and I'll show how to change it to 3 or 5 or whatever you think the inflation rate for the next year was going to be. The important part here is that we're using this reference cell, B14. Now, we can't just click and drag this formula across, because you'll notice it's not correctly applying that inflation rate like it is in cell B19. Look up here, and you'll notice that when we clicked and dragged, it's changing our formula. So it's updating the reference cell for us. Google thinks that we want to have a different inflation rate for every month of the year, and maybe we do. But in this case, we're going to assume we've got the same inflation rate for all of next year, and we want to calculate our whole budget that way. So in that case, we need to use an absolute reference, and that is the case where we use a dollar sign. A dollar sign in front of the letter tells us that we always want the formula, no matter where we drag it, to pull from column B. And if we put it in front of the number, it means we always want it from that same row here. So in this case, dollar sign B, dollar sign 14 means B14 is always going to be the cell for this formula. B3 doesn't have dollar signs. That's not an absolute reference. B14 with the dollar signs is. So B3, when we click and drag, will update for us, but B14 will not. And you'll notice that we can then click and drag those down, and we'll update those for us as well. And you'll notice that everywhere we click, the first reference cell, B3, for example, updates for us wherever we click. When we clicked and dragged down, it updated correctly. But B14, because it's an absolute reference, didn't change at all, which is exactly what we want to see, because that allows us to update the inflation rate and see what it would look like with 5% inflation or 10%. You'll notice all of these formulas use the reference cell and these additional reference cells above to update our chart below. That saves us an enormous amount of time by having one specific cell, an absolute reference that can change everything for us. If you've got any questions, please let me know in the comments. Otherwise, check out spreadsheetpoint.com for more advice on how to get more out of your spreadsheets.